Hi everybody, my name is Courtney Yando and I am a nurse at the hospital in Plattsburgh. And my main job is to help the doctors and the midwives there to deliver babies. So I think I have a pretty cool job. Today we are going to be reading Grumpy Monkey by Suzanne Lang. And he doesn't look very happy, does he? Reading is a fantastic thing to do in your spare time or when you have some free time, but it's also very important to know how to do on a regular basis, especially for my job. If doctors send in orders or, you know, write important emails, I need to be able to understand what they're saying. Because, for example, if I, you know, couldn't understand a medication that they wanted me to give, so I gave a wrong medication, that could cause my patients harm. And that is not what we want to do as healthcare workers. So, learn how to read. Very important. So, Grumpy Monkey by Suzanne Lang. One wonderful day, Jimpanzee woke to discover nothing was right. The sun was too bright, the sky was too blue, and the bananas were too sweet. Jim was confused. "What's going on?" "Maybe you're grumpy," suggested Norman from next door. "I am not grumpy," Jim insisted. On his walk, he met Marabou. "Jim's grumpy," Norman told Marabou. "Why are you grumpy, Jim?" asked Marabou. "It's such a wonderful day."
"Grumpy? Me? I am not grumpy," said Jim.
"But look at how you're standing," Marabou said.
"It's true," said Norman.
"You're all hunched."
So Jim loosened up.
Then he ran into Lemur.
"Jim's grumpy," Norman told Lemur.
"Why are you grumpy, Jim?" asked Lemur.
"It's such a wonderful day."
"Grumpy? Me? I am not grumpy," said Jim.
"Your eyebrows look grumpy," said Lemur.
"It's true," said Norman. "They're all bunched up."
So Jim raised his brow. Then he tripped over Snake.
"Oh no," said Norman. "That's the last thing you need when you're feeling so grumpy."
"Grumpy? Me? I am not grumpy," said Jim.
"Then why that frown?" said Snake.
"I think it's because he tripped over you," Norman whispered to Snake. So Jim put on a smile.
Finally, Jim looked happy, but he didn't feel happy inside. Everyone wanted Jim to enjoy this wonderful day.
"You should sing with us," said the birds,
but Jim didn't feel like singing.
"You should swing with us," said the monkeys,
but Jim didn't feel like swinging.
"You should roll with us," said the zebras.
Jim didn't feel like rolling.
"You should stroll with us," said the peacocks,
but Jim didn't feel like strolling.
"You should lie in the grass."
"You should stomp your feet."
"You should take a bath
and make a splash."
"You should hug someone."
"You should laugh."
"You should take a nap."
"You should eat some old meat
or some honey."
"You should jump up and down."
"You should sit in the sun."
"You should dance." But Jim didn't feel like doing any of that.
"Why are you grumpy, Jim?" asked the others.
"It's such a wonderful day."
"I am not grumpy," shouted Jim as he beat on his chest.
"He looks pretty grumpy to me."
And Jim stormed off.
And there he goes.
Jim felt sorry, a little sorry for shouting at the others, but mostly sorry for himself.
"I guess I am grumpy," Jim sighed.
And just as he was starting to feel really sad, he came upon Norman. Norman was slumped, his eyebrows were bunched, and he was frowning.
"What's the matter? Are you grumpy?" asked Jim.
"No, I danced with a porcupine," said Norman. He's got all the quills in his butt.
"Are you okay?" asked Jim.
"It hurts, but I'll probably feel better soon enough," said Norman.
"Are you still grumpy?"
"Yes," said Jim, "but I'll probably feel better soon enough, too. For now, I need to be grumpy."
"It's a wonderful day to be grumpy," said Norman, and Jim agreed.
And he already started to feel a little bit better. So that is the end of Grumpy Monkey. I hope everyone has a wonderful day and learn how to read.